gang violence, gun laws, and the Black Lives Matter movement is a joke in California. I almost became a statistic a while ago, a few minutes ago. I should say all the stuff mentioned and Jack in the Box are a joke in California. I guess I'll be careful with saying what just happened. Because I could be blowing it out of proportion, but from what I saw, I wasn't. Because technically it was legal, but my Marine Corps instinct with training with different sort of infantry units, having breaking bread with outlaws, I know this was not good. So I'm eating here at a Jack in the Box here in LA, Los Angeles. And I get a corner seat. I could see down both ways of the people coming in and out of the restroom, people coming into the main entrance. Some black dude is with his chick facing toward, the black dude is facing towards the restroom, minding his own business. And I see three black dudes, two black dudes and a black chick, black driver, black big ass, muscular upper body built, muscular black passenger, and a little skinny black passenger. And, I can tell that by the way that they're at the female parks, not even completely in a parking space, at not completely in, and also at an angle, easier to drive off on from that point of, from that point. But as the dudes get out, I could see them in a hawk-eyeing this guy. Just he's not mad dogging them, he's not throwing gang signs at them, he's not even looking intimidating. He's just there with his chick, and I'm pretty sure being hood that this guy probably saw them out of his peripheral vision. But these dudes walk in, and I was like, fuck, you bitch. If these guys have a gun, I'm fucking up. Shit, I gotta charge him. How am I gonna charge him? Looking at the hoses there. Mostly females, a dude way out on the corner eating some fucking nerd. Fucking living in the fairyland, just chewing his burgers, listening to his headphones. Like, I'm not gonna get back up. And it's simply gonna be a fight of adrenaline here. This guy, I'm thinking, fuck. I could tell that this is a strong motherfucker. I could tell either he works out, no doubt. This guy works out, strong upper body strength, big. This guy pulls out a firearm. Fuck, it's gonna be toast for me. But because I would have to charge him. I would have to. I don't know if this dude's gonna just shoot this guy or shoot all the witnesses. definitely my blood is pumping, and I'm trying to finish my burger. Trying to look calm, try to just focus on the burger wrapper in front of me. And not trying to bring attention that I'm paying close attention to these fuckers that are simply not even ordering the food, but looking around, scoping this guy out to see if he notices their entrance. And they start asking what comes on this burger or that burger. That burger does come with lettuce, tomato sauce, what's on it? And you could tell that they're trying to seem legitly to be there, because obviously the Jack in the Box employees are just there to take the order. Maybe this guy's tripping, not adding 1+1 that there's another Negro there, another precious black life, right? And I say that because of the Black Lives Matter movement, but I could tell that these fuckers, these two bastards that walked in were, I could tell that the little guy was following around the bigger guy. Like, I'm gonna follow his lead. You could tell he was there for backup. And, yeah, this fucker had to be strapped, because he had to be, man. I was just fucking lucky. Because if you're going to some other gang neighborhood shit, or approaching someone from a different set, or you don't know, you're not going to go there like, "Excuse me, sir, are you sporting a red or a blue rag?" No, it's this motherfucker looks at me funny, he's gonna get dumped on. And of course, technically nothing illegal is going on, right? Because no one's pulling out gang signs, no one's making death threats. But you could tell that some shit's about to they're looking for trouble. They're looking for trouble, looking to cause it. And of course, someone's gonna say, some people would say, you know, "You're being racist, you're being, you're overreacting, you're being paranoid here." You know, there's some things about my life that I've seen that I will not share. Because those are just things that you just see fucking, goon on goon violence, bad guy on bad guy, thug on thug violence, and you're like, fuck them, you know, it's, they weren't, purse snatching some innocent old lady, they weren't, picking on some nerd, these were fucking the savages eating the savages. So you know what, I'm just gonna keep on walking. I didn't see shit, I'm just gonna keep going forward. But this was a little bit different, because this wasn't it's man, because of course it sounds hypocritical, right? Because you're like, you know you should be saving, you should have done something about it. What bugs me is that this was around lunchtime, so you could see a couple of the other Mexicans that were there. You could tell that they were taking a break from what looks like a construction job, because of their paint on their jeans. Or their just their work clothes. It's not dirty, but it's used up. It's wear and tear on them. And I'm thinking in my head, man, these fucking idiots. They're gonna think of all sorts of shit, right? Like fucking Black Lives Matter fucking liars that they're about to do some stupid shit here. And me, man, what a fucking pathetic way to go. And right now, as I got home, I called the police department that monitors that area. The phone was ringing for 3 minutes, and I'm thinking, eh, fuck them. Because, you know, no crime was committed, but if I could tell the patrol, the cops, to just monitor that section for today, because these are obviously fucking definitely a populated area, definitely. It's a trip because when you see dumbasses kicking some of the dumbasses' ass, the way I see it is, you know, that's what they signed up for, and that's what they wanted to join. Let them play gangster, and let them let all that testosterone out. But and the way that Black Lives Matter woman is a joke is that a lot of these Black Lives Matter punks, they don't tell any of their cousins, their uncles, their brothers, their neighbors, their best friends. Hey, dog, they chill the fuck out, you know, with that that gangster shit. Chill out with that stuff, man. We don't need that. And some people could say, you know what, it's 100% them, because you know, no one told them to join the gang, and you know, it was their parents' fault. And you start thinking, well, I start thinking about the welfare system. The fact that, not the fact, but the acceptance that, you're a single mother. You can raise this kid on your own. That's cool. You're a strong woman. Cool, you know. But what happens when there's no father there to show them, son, you know what, you and your boys, you and your friends, you guys, there's no need to form a gang. You just become best friends, good friends. And there's no reason to sport a rag, a blue one or a red one. There's a problem, handle it one-on-one. don't pick up someone else's karma because of someone else's gang's history. There's no one there to show them that, teach them that. And some could say, you know what, that's their problem, you know. All these niggas need to take care of their own shit, you know. They can't be civilized like us. You know, when Obama went golfing just recently, during the other hurricane in Louisiana, that shows that what the black people really mean to a politician. I got your vote, dog. Fuck you. I don't need you anymore. Oh, fucking your neighborhood's underwater. That's nice. Don't get that shit on my imported Italian shoes. You know, I'm about to go on vacation because Hillary or Trump wins. Doesn't matter. I got my Secret Service. Y'all motherfuckers can go ahead and kill each other. I got bodyguards. Not my concern. Me and my family are 100% okay. And they're fucking idiots like the sexy ass Janelle Monáe. Seth MacFarlane, creator Family Guy, now bankrolling Hillary. Sexy ass Janelle Monáe, big booty Janelle Monáe, nodding her head with Obama, Kardashian whores and Kanye taking pictures with the evil, corrupt Hillary, the despicable, stupid Ellen DeGeneres, out of touch Ellen DeGeneres, taking pictures, trying to make Hillary Clinton look human. And all that shit gets mixed up together because we say, you know what, that's not our problem. That's a problem from the hood, from the ghetto. And it somewhat is. But when we divert taxes that could be improving our infrastructure, creating libraries, creating after-school programs, training teachers further with communication, psychology, so they can remain and become better communicators and teachers for our youth. Instead, we use that shit for our fat fucking asses, you know. Our fat asses, we need to get more oil. We need to go defend our oil overseas because, you know, we need to hook up our SUVs. We go Christmas shopping, use our credit cards to fuck around. And hey, it doesn't matter if you're a single baby mama or baby daddy, you know what? Don't worry, the welfare system will take care of that. The kid's not going to starve. Instead of the time when, you know, oh my goodness, did you hear little Susie is pregnant and she isn't married? And of course it's silly to let the other people's opinion lower your self-esteem, but when we start saying, oh, you know what, there's one thing if I go ahead into my kitchen and spill some milk and be like, fuck, I fucked up because I sneezed, because I was thinking about some big booty girl, thinking about Janelle Monáe's big, nice, juicy ass, because I was thinking about a burger special or something, and fuck, I fucked up, spilled milk. Now, it's another thing to say, you know what, yeah, I got pregnant, so what, I knocked this chick up, so what, you know, it'll take care of its own. No.
I don't think so.
And when we stop criticizing, it's hard, right? Because, you know, in one way you want to be respectful, share your insight, maybe share some criticism, but then there are bastards that pretty much just insult and don't bother to dissect the situation. They don't hold themselves accountable for the amount of confusion they've contributed to the situation. We'll see. And why are gun laws a joke in this video? Well, me, I've got no. I don't have a record, right? I don't have a record. I've trained with the M16A2 service rifle. He bred a 92FS Glock Model 22, 40 caliber Saw machine gun. I'm forgetting my the exact number. The 240 Golf was trained in that. Was trained in the automatic grenade launcher Mark 19. And I don't think it would take me very long to figure out how to use a mortar again. But me, I'm not allowed to carry a firearm under my clothing as I dine in a gang patrolled areas, you know. So yeah, but these, it's hit or miss with the gang member, right, that gets caught with the gun. Hit or miss. Hit or miss, hit or miss. I remember the other times where I've had to pull out my firearm to stop an assault, stop from someone getting robbed, someone else from getting stabbed. I remember how I didn't escalate things by brandishing the firearm and aiming it right away. But calculated as to how can I be ready to shit maximum 1 second to 2 seconds maximum to aim, properly grip the firearm, and aim it at the threat. But no, I can't carry that shit around here, because I'll get on lockline for a long, long time. It'd be pretty dumb if I get sent away with all these I'm gonna say that they're savages, but really they're really misled. And that's no excuse to be like, oh, you know what, you shot up this fucking neighborhood and shot at this idiot and you killed this little girl in the crossfire. It's okay, you've been misled. No, 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 no. I'm wondering more now if I should reassess my my neighborhood, because also the other day, oh not the other day, yesterday I saw a black assault at a Starbucks too. And the cops came and took care of that, but you know, that was more more entertainment, because it was just hand to hand. And also right before that assault, crazy dude walks in screaming, crazy black dude, right? And I'll say black just because people will say, yeah, you know, we need to take care of the solution, but the last 48 hours has been a total of 5 Negroes. And look, no doubt that there are Mexicans, Hispanics, Asians, well, not really Asians, but Latin and white criminals out there, no doubt, no doubt. But the Black Lives Matter movement that calls out race, I just want to point it out for them more than anyone else, them, because they choose not to call out the madness, call it out. But that's Los Angeles for you, and Jack in the Box. You never know what the fuck could happen out here. So I'm just assessing my situation here, because pretty much luck that I'm still here. But that dude's girlfriend definitely she noticed the threat, because she mentioned it, that she had got up with her friend or boyfriend. To be describing the dude that was there. Memory's gonna pull on this phone. I
All alone, they got like on the road.